Hi, I'm Crystle. As a child, I was always nurturing and naturally loved dolls. When I became an adult and discovered Reborn dolls, my little family started to grow. There's Haley, Landon, Avery, Chloe, Shiloh, Grace, Jamie, Jeremy, Maya, Yuki, and Savannah. Along with collecting, I have been a Reborn artist since 2008. It isn't easy keeping up with my collection, but it's a lot of fun.
Hey guys, it's Sunday evening and we just got back from my sister's where we gave my niece Morgan her baby. I did film it and I think I should be able to post it. So it may be posted before this video or after this video, we'll see. But I am just about to have some dinner. But I thought before I did that, I would start to get some Christmas things going around here. And I wanted to do it before the little babies here have to go to bed. So, first off, I thought I would show you Savannah. She is wearing her little outfit. If you guys remember my H&M haul back before she arrived here. I bought her this outfit and this is the first time she gets to wear it because it's finally cold enough that she can wear it. So it's this little onesie and it's got the little kitty cat on it and then the pink pants with the little white hearts and got the kitty cat socks, matching socks. And then she's got this little pink hat that has cat ears and a little white bow or a silver bow. No. Gray bow, sorry, on the one ear and then little white hearts. So she's chilling there with her brother and I'm going to leave them there, but I am going to gather up all the other babies because we are about to start our first Christmas tradition. So stay tuned. Also, Yuki is wearing her H&M outfit. It's the onesie, the long sleeve white onesie with the panda bear. He's got some bamboo in his hand. And then it's got like a, it's almost like a off-white color with black stripes. And then it's got the panda bear socks and the little stripy hat with panda bear ears. And it fits her perfectly. Like, amazing. I thought it was going to be too small, but it fits her perfectly. So the pants are a little bit snug in this area, but other than that, like, it fits her really well. So anyways, this is the last baby I have to take out. So Yuki, come and join us for some Christmas fun. Okay, guys. So we have a special story to read to get us started with the Christmas festivities. So, this is called The Elf on the Shelf. I wonder what will happen in this story. Have you ever wondered how Santa could know if you're naughty or nice each year as you grow? For hundreds of years, it's been a big secret. It now can be shared if you promise to keep it. At holiday time, Santa sends me to you. I watch and report on all that you do. My job's an assignment from Santa himself. I am his helper, a friendly scout elf. The first time I come to the place you call home, you quickly must give me a name of my own. Once you are finished, my mission can start. What will you call me? Sparkle or Heart? Will it be Foodle, Criddle, or Clyde? Fizbee's cute too, but you must decide. Each night while you're sleeping to Santa, I'll fly to the North Pole right through to the dark sky. Of course, Christmas magic helps me be quick. I laugh with my friends
and report to Saint Nick. I tell him if you have been good or been bad, the news of the day makes him happy or sad. A push or a shove, I'll report to the boss. But small acts of kindness will not be a loss. In the car, at the park, or even at school, the word will get out if you broke a rule. I'll be back at your home before you awake, and then you must find the new spot I will take. You'll jump out of bed and come running to see who'll be the first to spy little old me. Maybe the kitchen, the bathroom, or den is where you will find me, your special elf friend. I can hide on a plant, a shelf, or a frame. Where will I be? Let's make it a game. There's only one rule that you have to follow, so I will come back and be here tomorrow. Please do not touch me. My magic might go, and Santa won't hear all I've seen or I know. I won't get to tell him that you've said your prayers, or helped to bake cookies, or cleaned off the stairs. How will he know how good you have been? He might start to think you forgot about him. I can't speak to you, so says Santa Claus. All of us else have to follow his laws. I'll listen to you. Tell me your wishes. Would you like a game or some tiny toy dishes? The gleam in my eye and my bright little smile shows you I'm listening and noting your file. The final decision with Santa now rests. What do you think? Will you get your request? The night before Christmas, my job's at an end. The rest of the year with Santa I'll spend. So, blow me a kiss and bid me farewell. I'll fly away when I hear Santa's bell. Of course I will miss you, but wait till next year. When the holidays come again, I'll reappear. Until then, I wish every girl and each boy a Christmas of peace and a year full of joy. So, when we see this elf come to our house, we're going to have to name the elf, and he will report who's been naughty or nice to Santa. And remember, you can't touch him or her because the magic might disappear and you won't be able to tell Santa. So, we're gonna have to wait and see if we have an elf come and visit us. And then remember that the elf can't talk to you because they can only talk to Santa, but you can talk to the elf and tell them your Christmas wishes so that they can tell Santa. All right, so this is one thing we're gonna do this Christmas, but I have something else really fun we're gonna do starting tomorrow. Okay, guys, so we have this advent calendar, and it is 24 chocolate days till Christmas. So each day starting tomorrow, because tomorrow is December the 1st, we will open a square. We will have to find the number. It's all mixed up. So we'll have to find number one tomorrow and open it up. And there'll be a yummy chocolate surprise inside. So we're going to do that. And it counts down until the 24th, which is Christmas Eve, when Santa comes. Yeah. Is everyone excited?
Yay!
All right, I think it's going to be lots of fun. And now, Mummy is going to eat some dinner and get you guys ready for bed, and then it'll be time to start putting decorations up. So that should be fun. I don't know how much we'll get done tonight because it's getting late, but I'm gonna put up the decorations in the next over the next few days. Yay! All right, guys, just to kind of give you an idea of what to expect for the month of December. Basically, every single day, I will be choosing one baby to find our elf who hasn't visited us yet, but I'm sure they will soon. And so one baby each day will find an elf and open our advent calendar. And this is going to be regardless of what segment it is. It might be a doll break video where we continue on the video with Christmas activities, or it just could be like an in my shoes video, like a vlog thing where I'll, you know, start it off by having one of the babies find the elf and open the advent calendar. And even like Throwback Thursdays, Sing With Me Fridays. Basically, every single video will have part of our advent calendar countdown and finding the new place of the elf. So doesn't matter which segment, you will always see a baby in my video every day for the month of December. So it'll be lots of fun. I'm looking forward to doing this. I don't know, I just got thinking about some of the traditions I had as a child, which we always had the chocolate advent calendar. And I will be sharing some other things that I grew up with. Of course, Elf on the Shelf is fairly new, so I did not have that as a child. But I've always enjoyed looking at the funny pictures and the different ways people have found their elves each day and thought, you know what, even though I don't have a real child, I could, you know, role play it out and just pretend like if I did have a child, this is what I would do. So I think this is what I'm going to do for December. So I'm looking forward to it, but I'm starving. I'm going to eat some dinner and I'm hoping that I can get started on some of the decorating and show you guys at the end of this video. All right. So I have some Christmas music on. The new CD I got at the dollar store, that's awesome because it's the old classics. I am going to start by taking some of these things off of these shelves to make room for the Christmas decorations that I usually put up there. So this will soon be transferred over. Transformed, I should say. So these are all of the boxes that have our Christmas decorations. So this is a greetings from around the globe box that's going out. And that reminds me, I have to tell you guys that the second greetings from around the globe box did make its way to the person, and she did finally post a video about it, and she has sent it off to the next person. So I will be sure to share that with you guys. The link will be in the description below for this video. Because if I don't do it with this video, when I edit this video, I'll forget. This is our Christmas tree. We've just stored it back in the box it came in, but I'm thinking of like maybe eventually looking into this bag. I saw Alex's aunt, she had like a bag, like a zip-up bag that you store your tree in. And it was so much better because we always have to have tape like to hold it closed and it doesn't always work. And this bag is Rudolph from Build-A-Bear last year. Get him out. And this is some Christmas decorations in here. This has some Christmas decorations that I put out around the apartment, but it's mostly stuff to put on the tree. And then we have these two boxes of Christmas stuff, and then we have that there. So I'm going to get started now. I've dusted all of the shelves in the living room and removed everything that needs to be removed. And then I'll be ready to put the ornaments on there. So basically what I do is I store away the ornaments that I took off the shelves. I wrap them in the paper that the Christmas decorations were wrapped in and store them back away for the season. So I'm slowly getting things done. I'm hoping I can get maybe, well, the living room's almost done. The hallway's almost done.
So if I can get those finished, then all I'll need is Alex's help tomorrow night to put the garland around here. And then it should just be a matter of getting the tree done. So that'll be good. Guys, that's it. My knees have had enough. I'm tired. It is late and I have to get to bed so I can get up for work. And I've got to sort my pills before I go to bed. So I'm going to do that and call it a night. Thank you so much for watching today. And we'll see you in the next video. Bye, guys. You order pizza. Yeah. You order cheese sticks. Yeah. All right, the girls are about to watch the Kittredge movie. They're all set up here with their sleeping bags, all cozy with some, they're sharing some popcorn, and they've got their magazines and games for later on. And I'm about to paint some hair.